Hello dear viewer, today I want to talk about trains, the many-to-many train system and how to use the new interrupts to improve your rail networks. I set up this test world so that it's easy for you to see and follow what is going on. We have four loading stations for iron ore, all with the same station name. And four loading stations for copper ore with the same name. For each, we got two unloading stations. All of these stations have a train limit of one, because there are no waiting areas for a second train. We can only handle one train at a time. I also constructed a refuel station, which will come in handy later. And there's a huge waiting area for trains so that they can take a break and relax. Okay, let's start by setting up an old school many-to-many train system similar to the one I've used to create my Desert Death World megabase before Space Age launched. I will go into train interrupts in a minute, but I want to make clear that you don't need the new features or circuit logic to build massive train networks for large megabases. This is my first train, and I'm using train groups, which is a very cool feature that lets you add trains to a group easily without having to set up a schedule for every train individually. The schedule is very easy. Go to iron ore load and wait for full cargo. Then go to iron ore unload and wait for empty cargo. Because we have multiple loading and unloading stations with the same name, the game will automatically check which station has an open slot based on the train limits, and the train will go if a slot is free. Let's add even more trains, which is very easy with the train group feature, until we have 5. 5 is the maximum number of trains using this system for this schedule. Why? If you add up all iron ore stations and their respective train limits, we've got a total of 6 slots for trains in this schedule. But you have to keep at least one open slot at all times. Let's add another train to show you what will happen when using 6 trains. Boom, now we have a deadlock because every single slot is now occupied and all trains are waiting for a slot to open up. If I remove one of the trains, we are good again. We can do the same thing for copper transportation. Create a group for copper trains, use the same concept and add trains. It's important to understand that we have dedicated groups for each product, in this case iron and copper, and each group has its own fleet of trains. And if you respect the total amount of possible train slots, this works and scales very well. There's one problem though. How do we refuel our trains? Well, for each schedule there has to be at least one station where locomotives are refueled. For most schedules, there will be one station in your main base. But if you set up outpost to outpost transportation, it might be a struggle to ship fuel to one of the outposts. That's why in the past I used a mod called Train Refuel Station. But since Space Age, we have train interrupts to solve problems like this. Let's dive into interrupts and let me show you how it works. First, add a new interrupt and give it a name like refuel. Each interrupt must have a condition to determine if the interrupt should become active and therefore the next temporary stop. In this case, I use the condition fuel any locomotive. I want this condition to trigger when there's less than 5 rocket fuel in any locomotive. If that's the case, I want the train to go to the dedicated train refuel station. For the waiting condition, you can use fuel any locomotive again, or just full fuel. Let's test if the interrupt works. I will manually remove rocket fuel from one of the locomotives. As soon as the train heads off to the next destination, the interrupt should trigger. You can now see a temporary train stop. The train will now go to the refuel station and then continue with its normal schedule. My refueling station has a train limit of 5, which means up to 5 trains can leave the main line for the station and wait without blocking traffic. For refuel stations, this is important. You don't want to cause a traffic jam just because multiple trains need to refuel at the same time. There are more cool things you can use train interrupts for. For example, you can replace the unloading stop in the train schedule and replace it with an interrupt and the special wildcard item parameter. Here's how it works. I just removed the unloading station and added an interrupt. The condition is item count greater 0. But instead of selecting an actual item, I use this wildcard. For the interrupt target, I use the wildcard again and write wildcard unload. Okay, I admit it's not that easy to understand. But what the game does is it will check the condition and if there's any item that passes this condition. For example, there's a piece of iron ore on the train, then the interrupt will trigger. And on top of this, and that's the main feature here, if the wildcard triggers, the game will replace the wildcard icon in the target station name with the actual item that triggered this condition. So for example, if there's iron ore on the train, the interrupt will trigger The game will replace the wildcard signal in the target, which will turn the target station name to iron ore symbol unload. And that's exactly how my iron ore unload stations are called. For the interrupt target, you have to also set a wait condition. In this case, empty cargo inventory. Okay, why is it beneficial? Because we can now do the same thing with a copper train group. In a megabase, you probably have 20 different schedules. And if all unloading stations in your base have the same name pattern, you can use this unloading interrupt for all of your schedules in your entire base. Let's do more fancy stuff with train interrupts. In the beginning of the video, I already told you that I have a waiting area for trains. We also have to respect the maximum train limit capacity of each schedule. Let's create a train interrupt that sends trains to the waiting area if they don't have a valid destination or an open train limit slot. Add a new interrupt. In this case, I'm using the heart symbol and I call it the relax interrupt. And then add the condition destination full or no path. This will trigger if a train doesn't have a free train limit slot available. The target station is my chill station. And you have to add a waiting condition, like for example inactivity. Else other interrupts cannot trigger. And this is also the perfect time to talk about the checkbox at the top. The allow interrupting other interrupts checkbox. I'm using it for all three interrupts. If a train needs refueling, I want to go to the refuel station ASAP. And if the unloading interrupt already triggered, but destination is full, I want the relax interrupt to override the unload interrupt. The order of the interrupts is also very important. In this case, unload has higher priority than relax. I have to move relax up to interrupt unload. And as you can see, trains will now go to the waiting area until there's an open slot at the unloading station. I can already hear say, this is cool and all, using these interrupts for all schedules is amazing. But if we have 20 different schedules, we still need 20 different train groups, with the loading station being the only difference between them. Yeah, that's true, because unfortunately there's one feature missing in my opinion. The special wildcard parameter only works for items, liquids and fuel inside the train, or circuit logic signals. You sadly cannot set up an interrupt like this. I want the game to detect a loading station with this name pattern that isn't full. If that's the case, the game triggers the interrupt, replaces the wildcard so that the train goes to the loading station of this type. But again, it doesn't work like this. If you want to create generic trains able to work for all schedules, you have to use circuit logic. This is not really the topic of this video, but just as an example, I set up this interrupt with a circuit logic signal wildcard symbol and there's a test station with a constant combinator inserting a stone signal. The train goes to the test station and the circuit logic interrupt triggers, sending the train to the stone loading station. From there, it moves on using the interrupts we set up before until it goes back to test. This concept enables you to set up circuit logic to measure the amount of items in outposts or the demand in your base and send signals to trigger train interrupts. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and if you like this content, please subscribe to never miss future videos. Bye.